Selamat Hari Raya Idul Fitri and happy holidays to everyone watching. This is Mr. Toffee here. I'll be dishing out this week's video game and pop culture news highlights in 5 minutes or less. Just enough time for you to take a breather before your second or third helping of lemang or beef rendang. It may be just a few more days until all those juicy E3 live streams and awkward presentations go live, but there's still some awesomeness left to talk about, so here we go. Here are the latest E3 2019 rumors. We're getting a Watch Dogs 3. It's called Watch Dogs Legion, and it's set in London post-Brexit in the future where it's all messed up. And you can now take control of any character in the game with your lead hacking skills. Take away the end from NPCs. Shinji Mikami is attending E3 for business reasons, which means either one of these two things. The Evil Within 3 to be announced in Bethesda's press con, or Motherfucking Vanquish 2. The former is more likely than the latter, but hey, I can dream now, can I? Check out more details next week at E3 2019, so keep your eyes and ears peeled on our site for the freshness. Head to the link below for the full E3 press con schedule in GMT plus 8 time. That's for Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, and so forth. Nintendo's latest Direct video focused on Pokemon Sword and Pokemon Shield, which will be out for Nintendo Switch on 15th November. This new Pokemon will feature new Max Raid battles, where you and three other buddies, online or offline, fight against big badass Pokemons with upgraded super moves. These battles will net you a rare Pokemon if you get to whittle them down to a capturable state. Speaking of big, gym battles now let you use Dynamax on your Pokemons, making them kaiju-sized and ready to rumble against other gargantuan Pokemon. The Nintendo Direct video also showcased more new Pokemon for the British-influenced Galar region. But among them, the one that's garnering the most attention is Wooloo, who is getting a lot of love on the internet because of how fluffy he/she/it is. Aww, just keep in mind it'll eventually pop out on Rule 34 Threads. I just got evil life. After months of silence, Bethesda director Todd Howard speaks on IGN about Fallout 76's rough launch. He said that the team was ready for a lot of difficulties, and they knew that this isn't the type of game that people are used to, and is going to get criticism, well-deserved criticism. He ended things on this quote in context of the game's bad rep. "It's not how you launch, it's what it becomes, and I couldn't be prouder of the team that's worked on it." That's quite a spin on a game that's even more broken than past open-world Bethesda games, eh? You know what else people are used to, Todd? A good game. Hell, a competent game that works at launch. And you couldn't even do that. As much as we want to detail every single thing wrong with Fallout 76, we only have 5 minutes to work with on the show, so here's a quick one. After dealing with the Marvel Cinematic Universe with the awesome bookend called Avengers Endgame, Joe and Anthony Russo will be tackling the Magic the Gathering Universe via an animated Netflix series. They'll be teaming up with Hasbro's AllSpark Studios, Henry Gilroy of Star Wars The Clone Wars fame, Jose Molina of The Tick, and Bardell Entertainment for the animation. Based on the teaser pic, we may be seeing stories of this generation's planeswalkers like Chandra Nalar and Liliana Vess. It's nice to see the duo back doing TV shows. I mean, that's how they got their start from, after all. No Straight Roads, that wacky music-based action game from Malaysia's own Metronomic Studio, is pushed back to early 2020. They're delaying it from the intended 2019 release window because they need extra time to deliver on their vision for the game while sticking to their core values of providing a friendly, healthy workplace. It's also getting a physical release on PC and PS4, courtesy of publishers Sold Out. So yeah, have patience. There's a lot of giant-ass titles coming out in this second half of 2019, so this pushback is probably for the best. Speaking of which... say what you want about the shenanigans of Gearbox CEO Randy Pitchford, but you can't deny the passion the company has for its Borderlands fans. Gearbox will be paying a tribute to a terminally ill Borderlands fan named Trevor Eastman by adding in a legendary shotgun named after him. He also managed to play a special preview of the game after making a request and telling the Reddit thread about his cancer. A lot of people do give game websites a lot of flack for reporting sensationalist news, gossip, and the bad things they should be called out for. But remember, we also do cover the good they do, the yin to the yang, if you will. Just as companies like Gearbox have their downs, which we have to report to our readers, we too talk about the good they do as a way to show their appreciation towards their ever-loving and passionate community. That's all for this week's KKP Rhapsody. Until then, Selamat Hari Raya.
Selamat Hari Raya. Hari untuk kita bersukaria. Selamat kami ucapkan untuk kita hingga sampai tahun depan.